how are you all feeling? Hope you started your week well. I feel like I've been up for hours. It's an early start for me on a Monday. I hope you are feeling fabulous. Today we're going to do a mixed body class. We're going to start standing. We're going to mobilise, strengthen, and just feel generally better afterwards, hopefully. I know I will, because I know how exercise makes me feel. Let's have a quick hinge. Good morning, good morning. I can see someone messaging. Hi! Yes, well done for coming back before Christmas. You know what? We can all start slowing down before Christmas. I know there is a tendency to do that, but actually, if we just keep going, it's so much easier. And it's not about doing loads and loads, it's about putting it in when you can, which really we all can. It's just making that time for yourself. So well done, keep it going. And actually, a workout between Christmas and New Year, a few workouts, it makes you feel so much better. Okay, let's just come into standing. Big side reach. So I do try and keep moving over Christmas. Very easy to slow down, I know it is. And time is slightly more limited. We can squeeze it in, get the kids involved as well when they're on holiday. And a couple more inside. Always great for warming up that spine. Let's take the legs out, let's hinge down. Come all the way down, bending the knees, hands on the floor, lifting back up. Rotate from upper body. Good.
happening forward, and that's one. Stay with our hands here, take the leg out. We're just going to come up, tap it down, and we stay on the same side. Good, just exhale. Bring that knee up as high as possible towards that elbow to the side. We'll be working those obliques. Stay strong in your centre. Try not to lean forward, but to the side. Good. Lovely stuff. Keeping it there. Woo! Lots of balancing. Lots of core. Keep it going. Another four. Three. Great for the hips as well, hip flexor strengthening. And one. Staying here, hands on the hips, same side. We're lifting that leg. So we're staying strong through the waistline, which is going to really help work the obliques a little bit more into that bottom. Good, keep it there. Lift and lower. Try not to use momentum. Hold the down as well as the up. Good. Let's just think about those shoulders dropping down the back. Let's just now lengthen the arms to the side. Can you feel the shoulders squeezing? Another three, two, one. We're going to pulse it out for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Well done, release. Try not to grip through your foot too much. Spread those toes out. You may feel that you're gripping a little bit, so it might help stabilize. You really think about the weight going from big toe, little toe and heel. Are we ready? Tapping down. Onto the other side with those knee to elbow. Lovely. Keep it going. Draw that tummy in, keep thinking strong. Through your centre. Woo! Well done. Going for some more. Who's feeling this in their oblique? Hopefully you can. Hopefully you're feeling it in the legs, the hips. We're going for another. Five, are you ready? Supporting legs, you start feeling it. Shoulders down your back, squeezing together, and see if you can lift the knee a little bit further without tucking the pelvis, so that you're using those core muscles. Good. Voila. I'm going to turn this way. That's it. Now, what about your supporting leg? What's that knee doing? Is it rolling in or is it rolling out? It's rolling out, more inner thigh connection. Five. Well done. Four. Three. Two. One. We're coming up and then you can take the leg back. Coming out and back. So we're not going into the second leg yet. So you come down, come up to standing, take that leg back. Well done. Once you get used to the movement, you can start really lunging. The back leg is straight. So you get that nice stretch. Good. Well done. Let's slow it down. Bend that front leg. Come back up. Let's really look at where the knee's traveling. Good. Arms and shoulders. Should start feeling this. Now we're going for another three on either side. Good. Two. Last one. Coming up. We're staying in this position, doesn't matter what leg, we can do both. Just lifting and lowering. Squeeze from right underneath the bottom. And hold, have your hands forward if you want to challenge yourself a little bit more. Hips are square. Good. Another five, four, three, two, one, swapping sides. Good. Staying there. Five, four, three, lots of tummy, two, one. Coming into that leg drive now. Can you remember which one you did? Hopefully. Because we're doing the opposite one now. Drive those arms back. Lovely. Lots of tummy. It's not going to that low back. Good. Let's do another five. Four. Three. Three. I think you need to add some. Two. Two. And one. One. Well done. Coming up. Shake those legs out. Hopefully you've done everything that we did on both sides. Then come down onto the floor. Grab some water if you need it. Because we are, first of all, going to be coming all the way down onto our backs. We're just going to do a few pelvic tilts. So take your arms out to the side. Come into that neutral position. Let's just get those shoulders out behind us so the ribs aren't really flaring. Exhale, draw down in that neutral. Exhale as you tilt the pelvis onto the floor. You can have a little tuck if you like and lift up a tiny bit, draw that tummy in. Roll back, come into neutral. The reason we're doing this is because we're going to go into a reverse tabletop. I really want you to feel that scoop before you lift. Scooping on that exhale, coming back to your neutral. Imprint the spine, roll up the fraction. So it's a bit like going into a bridge or a spine curl, but we're only going a little way. So really get that movement into the lumbar area. So if you're tight in the lumbar, you're going to feel that opening. A few more. Good. One more. Are we ready? I'm going to come back up to seated. Hands are facing slightly out. feet facing forward. I'm going to scoop top, come up into that bridge, roll back down. So depending on how tight you are in the hips and the back lumbar, you might not be able to come very high up. Come back down and back up again. Keep lifted through the shoulders. As you get going, you may be able to feel everything loosening. Scoop and tuck, lift, push up. Good. I'm going to start feeling this in the arms. Taking a lot of weight. Good. Really scoop and roll. Drive up. Try not to let the knees turn out. If they are, grab a cushion or a ball, pop them between your legs. And squeeze. You'll get that extra little squeeze. Good stuff. Keep going. We're going for another five. Are you ready? Five. Lovely. Three. Two. We're going to stay up on this last one. One. We're going to squeeze the knees in and out. So I'm just going to turn a little bit so you can see. I'm lifting up, squeezing. Now if you've got that tap of the tailbone, like I have, I'm pushing the hips up, you will not be able to touch your knees. If I'm down here, I can touch my knees together. But when I'm up here, that's really tough. Good. Another. Five. And four. And three. Lift up in those glutes. And, woo, a little burner there. Let's just come back onto the mat. Draw the knees in towards the chest. Deep breath in. Rock from side to side. Good. Feet down. Woo, good. Can't need to pull the sleeves up. Too tight there. Okay. Well done, guys. Right, we're going to come back up into a reverse plank again. This time, we're going to straighten the legs. Now, I know some people find this really hard. So we're going to take it in our own time. You're going to flex your feet. Come up, tuck, point your feet, flex, point, and flex. And as you flex the hips, you're going to want to drop. So you can push up a little bit more. Come down. You can come up, point your feet, flex, point, back down. Or you can just keep staying up. I quite like the transition. You can do a couple here. It's probably a little bit easier without trainers on. I don't know what I'm talking about. Or you can just drive up and down. Flex, point, flex. We're working those calf muscles. Keep it going. Another five. Pushing up in between those shoulders. Squeeze the shoulder blades down your back. Good. Two. One. Coming right down. Well done. Just coming into seated. Are you feeling a little hot? We are going to grab our ankles. Have a little breather. So we're just going to lift the feet off the floor. Scoop that tummy, make a C shape in the spine as much as possible. Staying in that C shape. You're going to lengthen the legs if you can, all the way up, and then you're going to straighten up through the spine. And then you're going to C shape to bring the legs all the way back down. Drop the shoulders down. Scoop the tummy. Let's make that sort of ball shape with the spine. Take them up all the way. And then lengthen through the spine. Drop the shoulder blades down. And back down into that ball. The knees are apart when I'm in that ball position. So my hands and arms can come through my middle. Lifting back up, well done. And back down again. So just go your own time. Now, if you can't come all the way up to this point, I appreciate that not everyone can lengthen their legs. If you have bent legs, try and lift up through that chest. When you get to the point, point where you can't really lengthen the legs anymore. Well done. Two more here. And let's make a really small ball. Lifting up. Lovely. One more. As you come up, you will feel your core, your lower core has to connect a little bit more to lengthen through the spine. And coming back down, dropping those feet onto the mat. Take those arms out, roll back. Draw the tummy in. Drop the shoulders down your back. Come back up, lifting those arms. And drop back down. Scoop the tummy. How far back can we go? If you're tight in the lumbar, this is going to be challenging as you roll back. Arms. Really stay low for a little bit. Through breathing, can you draw that tummy in? Naturally, probably wants to push out as you roll back to exhale. Draw the tummy in. Keep drawing it in. Try not to push it out. Good. Four more here. Well done. You've got this. And three. Every time you get to the lowest part, draw that tummy in a little bit more. Two. Last one. And stay here. You can rotate, tap the hands side to side. Good. Try not to let the shoulders come up towards the ears. A bit like a Russian twist, but we're scooped into a slight C shape. Keep it there. Good. Five more. Keeping those knees still. It's the upper body that's moving. Woo. Draw that tummy in. Three. And two. And one. And coming up. Well done, guys. How are we feeling? Okay. Just going to come onto our elbows. And we're just going to scoop our bellies towards the mat. You can drop through the shoulders and then lift back up into that neutral position. So I'm now long and lengthened in neutral. And scoop back again. And coming back up. And again. Lovely. Two more. Lifting up. So you can really feel the difference in where the weight is. Going on the back of the pelvis and you scoop the tummy. And then as you lift up, it goes towards the tailbone. Last one, let's lift up, feel that weight through the tailbone. Elbow should be right under your armpits. Coming into a single leg stretch. Draw that tummy in. Use that out breath as the leg goes away from you. Good. And as you inhale, you want to think about your lateral breath. So you can keep breathing with that connection. So the lateral breath is where your ribs open up to the side, but you can still stay connected in your core. Use that breath. Good. Keep lifting throughout the collarbones. Well done, guys. We're going for another five. Four. Well done. Three. Two, and one, and bringing those feet down, well done. I'm going to turn over. How are we all doing? We might run a little bit more over 30 minutes. Hope that's okay with you. So, scoop and tuck. I'm enjoying it too much. And then release. And again, let's just tuck that tailbone. Really get that movement through the lumbar. You can come into extension or just back to neutral. Good. One more. Okay. We're going to come into a plank. One leg out. Make sure those hands are spread out across the floor. Really feel anchored towards the floor. We're coming from here. We're going to do a leg in, then the other, and then rotating into a side plank. Let's think about that core.
come into that side plank. Drive that knee in one, then the other. Put some speed through those, lifting up, back into that neutral plank position. Weight over the hands. Rotate, you've got this. Keep ducking the tailbone so that your bum's not sticking out behind you and the lumbar is getting more weight in that side plank. Squeeze the glutes a little bit. One more. Slow with those knee drives. Look up to the hand if you can. And do one more, either side after this one. Let's slow these down now. I'm going to hold each side plank for a little longer. Draw that knee in. And the other. Rotate. Push away from the floor. Deep breath in for three, two, one, and rotate. Drive those knees in. Last one, let's turn. Lifting up. Face your hand if you can. Three, two, and one. Back into plank. You're just bringing those knees down into rest position. Scoop the tummy away from the legs. Let's get that length through the spine. Deep breath in for two. We're going to come slowly out of this rest position in a second. And we're coming into a plank height, one leg. So we're going to be drawing that knee towards the elbow. Now, if you find it's too much, you can do it on the knee. I'll quickly demonstrate. If you're feeling it's too much, you can just stay here, bring the knee in. If you can go a little bit further, into the plank to start. Downward facing dog, you can lift that leg up and draw it in. Let's go. So 10 of each. Whether you're kneeling or like me coming from that height. One, I'd like to draw that leg in, lift the knee up and in. So all the way to the elbow and lift. Good. Five more. Four. Lots of tummy. Lots of upper body strength. Three. Two. Are you feeling strong? That's one. Lift. And back into that plank. Just come into downward facing dog or kneeling. Walk those heels out. Roll you back onto the knees. Back into rest position. Just take the weight of the palms just for a second. You can bring the arms all the way down to the sides. We're going to do the other set. In three breaths. Keep drawing that tummy off the floor. Can you reach your bottom onto your heels? If you can't, start there and then have the head off the mat and slowly come down. Doesn't matter if you can't reach all the way. If you've got a yoga block, it's quite a good way of feeling that you're getting towards the mat, pressing your head on the yoga block. Okay, I'll be ready. So if you want, you can just do that knee drive slow. You probably get to do a few more than 10 actually if you're doing those. Okay, into that plank. Down, push facing dog or plank. Leg up. Draw that knee up. Really work that core. Try and come all the way back into that plank. Not have the bottom sticking up in the air. Push into the hands. Good. Lift from the bottom. Let's do five more. Slow it down. Lift. Four. Three. Lift. Well done. Two. And one more. Woo.
question mark on. Not quite yet done.
So, from here, we're going to do a little bear tap and then into a plank,
and then we're going to start pulling down. So,
we're coming into 4-point kneeling. Weight right underneath that armpit. Let's just come into a bear hold, hop up. We're going to take the legs out, tap for two. And then take the leg out into a plank. You're going to hinge forwards and backwards for two. You're going to then bring those knees in, tap to either side, and do six sets of these. Back out, hinging, shearing in those shoulders. Bring those knees in. Make sure you're not sinking in the shoulders. Number three. Halfway, you can do this. This is a lot of upper body. Squeeze those shoulders down on your back. Good. Back in. Tummy should feel working. Into that shearing. Tuck that tailbone under. Number five. Then step four. Speeding through these. Those legs back into that plank, shift forward for two. As we are coming into the last one, do not let that go into your low back. If it is, come down, start again. Last one, tuck that tailbone under, fire up those glutes, bring the knees down into rest position. Well done.
Are we feeling that in the upper body? I hope so. Deep breath in and exhale. Well done, guys. We are
coming into some plank bike rolls as we start to pull down. Let's just take those shoulders down like that. How are we doing? Strong session today. Let's wiggle those hips. Body weight is so amazing for toning, for strengthening, for mobilizing. Tuck the tailbone, wiggle the hips. Good. Okay. One leg out, then the other. Just doing four of these. We're going to slow it down then. So into that pike or down facing dog, chest towards the feet. Walking the feet out for three or four. Then lift up the heels, scoop and roll back into the plank, squeezing those glutes. Upper body is lifted away from the floor. Back into downward facing dog. As I said, we're doing four of these. The closer the feet are together, the more challenging. Lift up onto your toes, squeeze the heels together if you can. Come back. Three. Walk it out. Chest towards the feet, not the head. When we take the head through, we really get that awful pulling feeling down the neck. Drop the heels, lift. Scoop and roll. Good. If you're really scooping, when you get into that plank position, you're going to really feel your bottom connected. Good. Well done. We've got this one today, team. Drop those heels, lifting up. Scoop. Hold that plank. Heels together. Squeeze the inner thigh. Shoulders down your back. For three. For two. For one. Coming down onto the knees. We're going to take one leg forward. Let's come into a hip flex stretch. If you want to get more of a hip flex stretch, you can come up. You can lean on this knee. Keep strong through your center. You can then also lift up and turn towards that knee. You'll get an oblique stretch as well. Just be careful with these. Sometimes when people start layering and they find it a bit uncomfortable, just go where you can. We can be down here. Tuck that tailbone under. Let's not sink in the lumbar and go into a back bend. You want to feel length. That's going to really get that hip flexor feeling long. Holding it there. Let's push that knee out a little bit. So get inner thigh and hip hamstring stretch. We all need to lengthen the hamstrings more than we do. It's just one of those things. Holding it there. Draw the leg back into the socket. Try not to let it go out. Feel like you're drawing it in. Hold that tummy. Good. Coming back. Bring that leg behind you. Swap sides. Ooh. Feeling a little tight on this side today. Okay. Really lengthen. Lift over. Make sure your core is strong. It's not all just being loaded through the back. Come back down. You may feel that is enough, that tuck. Bring the hands inside the leg, push that leg out. Good. Into a hamstring stretch. Well done, guys. And taking those legs back into four point kneeling. Just coming into the little extension. Look up. Scoop through the tailbone back into the cat. Try not to push too much in between the shoulder blades and the thoracic and the cat. You want the lumbar to be doing most of the work. Drawing that tummy in. This is a great core exercise as well in itself. As you tuck, zip up that pelvic floor, draw the tummy up and in. More after this one. And slowly come standing when you're ready. Tuck the toes under. Then facing dog, walking the hands towards the feet. Can you just hang over? Let's sway from side to side. You can just run your fingers along the floor. Good. Stay there for a few more seconds. Just stay still. Sending the weight forward over the toes. Are you feeling that down back of the legs? Deep breath in, let's just release everything to the floor. Can you feel around your shoulder blades, everything loosening? Just slowly feel the weight going out of your body almost. Towards the floor. Couple more breaths. And one more. Slowly roll up. Roll your hands all the way up to your legs if you want. It's quite a nice sensation, feel that rolling through the spine. Well done. As you come up to standing, rotate those shoulders. Squeezing those shoulder blades down your back, opening the palms forward. Let's just take the hands out. Lift them up slowly to your side, bring them back and elbows squeezing into my waist so my shoulder blades are connected. And again. And one more. Release the hands down to the floor. And just reach to one side. Let the head drop. Let everything release in the neck. Good. Go to the other side. Really reaching that hand down towards the knee. One more either way. Try and release the neck. Get so much tension through the neck. And back up to standing. Lift those arms up. Bring the hands to your heart center. Deep breath in. Close your eyes if you really want to feel that deep breath going into the body. All that positivity and exhale. Release those hands. Shift your legs. Well done, thank you to those who join me live. I love having you on live, and I know we try and alternate the time so everyone can join, but it can be challenging. So when we get a big group, it's always lovely to have you on board. I hope you enjoyed that workout. I definitely did. So I'm hoping you did too. This schedule, sorry, is going up a bit later. There was a bit of movement with the trainer, so I didn't want to put up something that I needed to change again. Oh, I'm so glad to have you back. It's lovely to have you back here. So thank you for coming. I hope you're feeling well and fit and ready for lots of lovely workouts. So I will see you later on in the week. The schedule, as I said, will be up later on today. So have a great day. Happy Monday. Enjoy the sunshine if it's sunny where you are. And I will see you soon.